हेलो एवरीवन, सो टुडे वी आर बैक विद द थर्ड पार्ट ऑफ कंट्रोल योर मूड कंट्रोल योर हॉर्मोन्स। दिस वीडियो इज गोइंग टू बी अ लिटिल बिट बिगर बिकॉज वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट अ ह्यूज लिस्ट ऑफ हॉर्मोन्स टुडे। एंड फॉर टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट पिट्यूटरी ग्लैंड। इन पिट्यूटरी ग्लैंड इट रिलीजेस मेनी हॉर्मोन्स। इट इज ऑल्सो रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर मर्जर ऑफ हॉर्मोन्स। इट इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर the feedback of the brain to release another hormones in different part of the body. So it is very important to know the pituitary gland. First and foremost, there are few glands in which give feedback according to the pituitary feedback. Okay, so feedback is very much important in the brain cycle. So what is feedback? Just like the ordinary term feedback, feedback inside our brain, it refers to giving a signal to another gland to release or stop hormone secretion so that the other part of the body gets more benefit. See, sometimes few hormones inside the pituitary get released and it stops the production of another hormones to balance the body, the balance thermal heat, balance stress, right? So that is called feedback. The pituitary gland and its hormones are also responsible for giving feedback to different hormones inside the body. So let's start today's session. There are more hormones related to pituitary gland, so that this video will become a little bit longer. But those who are really insisting to know more about how to controlling their mood, how to handle their mood swings biologically and technically, they should really understand this, all these hormones. So first of all, the most famous hormone of the pituitary gland is dopamine. So what is dopamine actually? See, dopamine is something which reduces the amount of stress level in the body by giving pleasure sensations. So when you are not feeling motivated in your life, when you don't like to do something in your life, when you are not feeling pleasurable, when you are not having good sex drive, when you are not feeling happiness with others, right? So that is the issue of dopamine. So first and foremost, dopamine is something which will make you anxious, which will make you fatigued, which will make you moody, right? So whenever you are moody, when you are anxious, whenever you are like you want to have cravings of sugar, you have cravings of caffeine, coffee. So these are all symptoms of less production of dopamine, right? So what we need to do is we need to address our body to give a positive feedback to release dopamine. And when the dopamine is released, the circadian rhythm of the heart arranges, and when the circadian rhythm arranges, you feel pleasurable. See, any time the circadian rhythm or circadian clock is messed up, you will feel extremely moody. Your body's rhythm will go. See, people talk about synchronizing, manifestation. So these are all terms which have a very deep meaning, but these days people only focus on the upper level of the water line. But the water is very much deep inside. So the sink in the external vibes come when the internal sink is regulated. When your circadian rhythm is regulated, when your breathing cycle is regulated, when your hormones are regulated, after that there is a sink inside your body. After there is sink inside your body, synchronization will start around your body and your vibes. And when the synchronization around your body and vibes starts, your vibe field, your electromagnetic vibes get synchronized. Right? So it is very important to synchronize your inner self to synchronize the output of electromagnetic radiations, electromagnetic waves around your body. So if you want to enrich your vibes, synchronize your vibes, you need to synchronize your circadian rhythm, you need to synchronize your sleep clock, you need to synchronize your body tendency, you need to synchronize your pH, you need to synchronize your thermal balance. And for all these different hormones are made up. For circadian rhythm, the best hormone is dopamine. When you balance your dopamine, your circadian rhythm is good. That means now we are more adaptive with things in the world. You are feeling more pleasure. The less the dopamine, the less pleasure you feel. You will be more in anxiety. You will have mood swings. That is all the symptoms of lack of dopamine. It also changes your body temperature sometimes. Okay, it will take you higher to the heat. Okay, the thermal level will increase. So talking next is the muscle movement. It also controls your muscle movement. So what is the feature of muscle movement? That if your stress is basically nothing else but the muscles which are stretched, having less connectivity of neural signals and less sensitivity. See, there is a difference between stress and tension, hypertension, anxiety, everything. So stress is something where your muscles get tighter. When the muscles of your upper neck, the cervical, upper cervical, and your subconscious mind becomes stressed, then it is hypertension. If your nerves and muscles of this area and side regions get stretched, then it is stress. If muscles of the temporomandibular joint over here it is stretched, then it is frustration. So different muscles give rise to different moods. If your muscular movement is very smooth, if you are flexible enough in your body, you can rearrange your muscle movements, you can rearrange the circulation inside your body. So what does dopamine also do? Dopamine also balances the muscle movement in your body. So the lack of dopamine will create rigid muscles. You will have muscular issues sometimes somewhere, like in the neck or in the head or in other part like rhomboid muscle inside your back near your scapula. So there would be different muscular strains in your body, and that will cause a lack of feedback. And when there is no proper feedback, there is irregulation of hormones, and this irregulation of hormones will create problems. Okay, so dopamine is something which regulates your muscle movement, which makes you feel pleasurable, which gives you happiness, it releases your anxiety. Okay, and how to boost this naturally? For boosting this naturally, you can eat raw sugar, sugar. You can eat coffee, you can eat nuts, you can eat watermelon, you can eat pumpkin seeds, you can eat eggs, right? All these things increase dopamine level. But see, whenever you want to affect your hormonal system, eating it once won't make a difference. In all this video, I am giving you food suggestions, right? There are food suggestions in each and every hormones I am giving you. But don't think that if I am telling you to eat this and you eat that and you feel good. No. You have to continuously eat these things 3 times a day for minimum 7 days to attain a balance in your hormone. First eat 3 times a day, then eat 2 times a day, then eat one time a day, then eat alternate day, and then release it. So your body tendency is automatically set. So if you see your dopamine level is going down, you are seeing these all symptoms inside you, then increase such things in your diet for 7 days, then reduce slowly and slowly. Dark chocolate is very good for dopamine. You can keep dark chocolate inside your mouth for at least 3 to 4 times a day if you are not diabetic. Okay. So these are all good points of dopamine. Another thing it regulates is body temperature, as I said. So more and more you drink water, the dopamine action will enhance, because it is also responsible for muscle movement, right? And muscles need water. When there is dehydration, the first issue from dehydration is your muscles get rigid, they start getting strained. And when such things happen, the body temperature will always rise, because now there is lack of circulation. the lack of circulation and more pumping. Your circadian rhythm has gone, your pumping is more increased and your movement is less. So what will it create? It will create more thermal energy which is not consumed inside the body, and that thermal energy which is not consumed in your body, not consumed in your Manipura chakra, not consumed in your stomach, will radiate out. How will it radiate out? Firstly, it will radiate out from squamous tissues, your skin. It is more than it is going to be radiated out from your mouth and from your stomach, causing acidity and heartburns. That is the second stage. Third stage is diarrhea. Okay, because heat is not controllable. It is going and flowing everywhere inside the body. So whenever you are on less dopamine and you want to increase and you are eating such foods, also increase the hydration in the body. Drink more water. Train your body to suck the water when you are sleeping. Drink 2 glasses of water before you sleep. For 2 days, 3 days, you need to get up for urination. For 5th day or 6th day, it will reduce, you will wake up late. After 7 to 8 days, you won't wake up. Your body will gain a tendency to absorb water while you are sleeping. So drink 2 glasses of water before you sleep. It will give you irritation, it will make you wake up in between the night for around 7 to 10 days. After that, your body will get adjusted. Okay. So drink more water when you are on increasing dopamine. So this was all about dopamine. Another thing is, when you are also low on dopamine, your focus is not there, you will lose focus. So whenever you are feeling that you are not having focus in your life, try to increase dopamine. Right? See, happiness hormone is serotonin. When you are happy, you are not focused. So if you want to be more focused, you will always have to be more on dopamine. Your dopamine level should be more than serotonin levels. That is how you will gain a very good focus. But that will reduce your happiness. Because when you are more focused, you are more observant. When you are more observant, you are more analytic. You are more analytic, you are less responding, you are less responding, you are less happy. Happy people respond more, think less. So this was dopamine. Lack of dopamine also creates Alzheimer's and ADHD in long term. So it is good to control it whenever you feel it is going down. The next hormone is adrenocorticotropic hormone, and it is responsible for negative feedbacks. So what is negative feedback? Negative feedback is something that release of that hormone will give a negative feedback to the other gland in your body to stop producing some other hormone. That is called negative feedback. Right? So this hormone actually governs two other hormones, which are cortisol and adrenaline. Right? So cortisol and adrenaline are two hormones which are associated with this hormone. The feedback of these hormones controls another two hormones. Okay. Secondly, it is responsible for your conditional behavior, cognitive functions. Conditional behavior is how you behave in front of different people. If you are not able to distinguish your behavior in front of different people, your social life, you are seeing you are the same person with everyone, which is creating an issue, then this hormone is a main problem. So if you want to increase your cognitive function, if you want to increase your prefrontal lobe, this one, if you want to increase your conditional behavior, then you have to handle this hormone, because a simple change in this hormone will give two changes, one in cortisol, another in adrenaline. Right? So increasing this increases your cognitive function. Firstly, it will give a negative feedback to cortisol. Whenever cortisol is given a negative feedback, your body temperature and thermal heat changes, and as soon as your body temperature and thermal heat reduces, you are less spontaneous. You will think and respond. When your body heat is high, you will get more spontaneous. And what mistakes do spontaneous people do? They respond. which is wrong. What you should really do is to think and then respond. Then again think about the response and then think. Then again think and respond. So it is a two-way cycle. Think, respond. Think about the response. Think about the next response. Respond. Think, respond. Think about that response. Think about the next response. Then respond. So think, respond, then two times think, then respond. Then again two times think, then respond. This is the basic functioning of the feedback you should be having. I'm not saying you are having. A lot of people are not having this kind of response system because their brain is not naturally trained to respond specifically. You train your brain to respond specifically. So training your brain responses is a skill. You need to acquire that skill by regular practicing the respondents between everyone. And it will, I am going to tell you, it will take years. Minimum 2 to 3 years you have to adapt to things. You analyze different people. You see how you are interacting with people to people. You analyze other people. You analyze which response is better. You analyze how to think on response. You analyze when not to think on response, when you are going into overthinking. So it is a very big process, but you need to master the skill if you want to really master your mind. So coming back to adrenocortisol. So this hormone, as I said, increases your, gives negative feedback to cortisol, it reduces your body heat, and in turn it balances your, cognitive function, as I said. And it also governs your limbic muscles. So it is very important if your limbs are getting tightened, if you are having muscular problems in your limbs, just in limbs, not in another part, just in limbs, then it is this hormone. If there is in another part, there are more muscle problems in your body, on your this main frame of the body, then it is dopamine. But not in the main frame of the body and the peripheral in limbs, in your hands and legs, then it is ACTH. Okay, so this is the difference, this is the distinguish, how you distinguish and which hormone issues you are having. You need to concentrate on yourself first. So this is it. In this, if you want to increase this, you eat more nuts. Okay, this, when you are lacking this hormone, it will also reduce your sex drive. It will also reduce the experience you are having while having sex. It is also going to affect your mood, you know, very task, and it is going to make you more aggressive, more rageful sometimes, because your body heat will become uncontrollable and your respondents will become uncontrollable. So it is very important to handle that. So we have foods like nuts, then you can have like eggs, apples, watermelons, pumpkin seeds, right? All these things help, but you have to include these things in regular diet. Have more oatmeal, have more milk, right? Don't be a vegan again, have milk. And another thing is adrenaline. Just like it gives negative feedback to cortisol, it gives positive feedback to adrenaline, right? So it also controls adrenaline, it also controls your spontaneous response. So it is very important to control these hormones, because when this hormone is imbalanced, and it is affecting your adrenaline level along with this hormone, it will give you lack of appetite. First of all, your appetite will go down. So what will happen when your appetite will go down? After your appetite is lowered, the second symptom it will be having is a lack of sex drive and cold sensitivity. Your body will remain cold and it will be sensitive to cold. Just like the negative feedback to cortisol is making your body warm, when the adrenaline changes, it will give you more cold sensitivity. And when the cold sensitivity increases, you will not be feeling in the rhythm. You will feel a lot of fatigue. You will feel in a depressed mood. You will feel exhausted, right? Talking something deeper about sex, many people don't know. We are not over here taboo fearing people, so we are talking. See, sometimes what happens when you are having a very rough sex, when you are having a too nasty sex, and someone has the tendency to give you exhaustion while having sex. You see, there are two to three types of sex. Pleasurable sex, which is slow and soft sex, which will release different hormones in your body. Then it is something which gives like a wave form of sex. You get rough, you get soft. Okay. That is going to give you different forms of hormones in your body. When you are having a sexual experience with a person who is giving you a very rough sex experience, who is giving you a boost in adrenaline. See, whenever you are having sex, especially women, they are having sex and the male is dominating, even when the female is in a charged form, even when she is charged and onto the peak, and the masculine male is dominating and not stopping, at that time the adrenaline will boost in your body, right? So what will happen to this? What will happen? The adrenaline level will go high, and at one certain point, when the body capacity to understand the response and feedback reduces, the adrenaline goes very much high, it gives you faint, it gives you blackouts, and after the blackout, after the fainting nature, you fall down. The adrenaline level falls down. So what happens when you finish your sex? You finished your sex not over here, you finished your sex over here. Right? The normal sex pattern, when you finish your sex, you should feel charged up. You shouldn't feel drained. When you are feeling drained, the opposite partner has pulled out a lot of energy from you. He has enhanced your adrenaline, and when your adrenaline is enhanced, you are more hypersensitive. All your pores of the body are open from goosebumps, and everywhere the energy is flowing out in bulk because adrenaline rush is taking place. And at that stage, if someone pulls energies from you, you get drained and get energy less, and then you fall down like this, like a graph. The energy graph falls down. So what happens? Your energy graph falls down and the graph of another person has risen up. Okay. So why it is loss for you? It is a fucking loss for you, because whenever the hormone level is going down, and adrenaline has gone very down, it will make you cold. Your body will be totally cold. You will be having chills. You will be having a lot of fatigue. And after that, even after you sleep, you wake up next morning, you will not be charged. Your energy is going down. So just to have the peak pleasure for 15 minutes, I will not say 15 minutes also, because that moment of peak will only be there for around 1 to 2 minutes. For that 2 minute pleasure, you are giving out all of your energies, and then you are reducing your graph. Now that loss of adrenaline and the energies which have gone out, it has disturbed your circadian rhythm, it has disturbed your synchronization, it has disturbed your body clock, it has disturbed your muscular balance, it has disturbed your thermal balance, you have been disturbed totally. So it will take months to recover from that adrenaline down. For how much minutes? 2 minute pleasure. For that 2 minute pleasure, you are going 6 months below of your energy level. Especially women. Men don't have issues because the adrenaline level in men is different. So this is the main issue that women face in having rough sex. With every rough sex, you are increasing your pleasure form of the body. And whenever you increase this pleasure form of the body, you are going down the next day. And whenever this adrenaline level goes down, your body is cold. You are having chills. The total thermal balance of the body is gone. 90% of energy is radiated out from that, 80% is gone to the masculine dominant male, and the 20% is radiated in the environment. So you are drained. And next 6 months or 3 to 4 months, you will keep on trying to obtain that energy from environment. And if you are having recurrent sex like this, you are going to reduce your physique, you are going to reduce your fat inside the body, you are going to get slimmer and slimmer and slimmer. Okay, because your thermal body is changed and everything is changed. So, adrenaline rush is a very deep topic. It will take hours and hours if you are going to talk about adrenaline over here, especially with me. So, we are not going to go very much deep. I am just discussing this because it is very much important to know that if you are trying very much to balance your hormones, balance your mood and balance your body, it is very much important to know what kind of sex is really needed for the body. The body doesn't need extreme sex. Your pleasure and your needs need extreme sex, because after every extreme, there is lower extreme. You go extreme up, you fall extreme down. Basic rule of nature. You go extreme up, you fall extreme down. So always go up and down, up and down. Don't go extreme up, you will fall extreme down, you will take months to recover. So it is very important to handle your adrenaline. We talked about sex just because in sex it is very much probable to disturb your adrenaline balance, ACTH balance, cortisol balance, and all these things will hypercortisolemia, depression. It is a kind of depression. See, whenever you have a large and a very rough sex, where your adrenaline rush is going up, you are getting blackouts, your brain cannot understand that adrenaline rush. Till that stage you are having sex and the male is still dominating, and after that your adrenaline will go down and down and down, and your body tendency will become to release adrenaline and go down and down and down. Your body thermal heat will go down, you will get chills, you will get cold sensitivity, and all these things will reduce the natural tendency of the body, making your muscles tighter and tighter and tighter and tighter. You will have the problem of frequent urination, because now your hydration capacity to handle water has become less. Okay. So all these problems will start, and these problems will give rise to muscular imbalances, which will imbalance the flexibility of your muscles inside your body, inside your brains, and that will again cause hypercortisolemia, depression. It is a kind of depression, and that depression will give you very worst mood swings. It will give you something like hopelessness. You will feel your life is hopeless, and all these things are happening because of too many pleasure. So understand till where you have to reach and give limits in everything in life. Okay. So this was about adrenaline and cortisol governed by ACTH in your mind. So the next hormone is vasopressin. Okay. This is a very important hormone, and many people don't know this, but it is a very much, it plays a very significant role in the selfish behavior of people. See, there are verses in our Indian mytho, Indian Vedas, Indian ancient books. They say that the nature of person is not to be judged by who they are, but how they live. See, that is because every nature, anything a mind thinks, the way of action, the way of reaction, the complete nature of the body governs the nature of your mind. What you eat, you become. That's what people say. But there is one more step. What you eat, how you regulate, that's who you be. Again, what you eat, how you regulate, that's what you be. So this vasopressin hormone is something which is making people selfish. Because first of all, it is responsible for neural circulation, how your brain gives signal, signaling inside your body. The overall feedback mechanism is controlled by this vasopressin. This is also responsible for your social behavior. Because when you are having a good social behavior, you are thinking about cooperation and not selfishness. Selfish people don't have good social behavior. I am not saying social life, I am not saying social appearance, I am saying social behavior. So this hormone is something that is giving you a need of cooperation. It will let you enhance your emotional quotient. It will help you understand the emotions of opposite person. It is going to help you to see a perspective of beneficiary of both yours and opposite person. So it is very much important in the negotiating aspect of brain, how negotiable you are, how much selfish you are, how much you think about yourself. Why do some people think more about others? Why do some people think more about themselves? This is all due to vasopressin. Vasopressin is something which governs your social behavior. So, whenever you are more selfish, whenever you are having more selfish thought, you are thinking about yourself, you are not thinking about others. This is the issue of vasopressin. Moreover, this vasopressin is generated by both men and women. But men are easy to develop these skills because this hormone reacts more with testosterone, which is the main factor hormone of masculine growth. Females they don't have mass release of testosterone. So it is very much important that men control vasopressin. Because it is something which reacts both with your masculine nature and with your selfishness. It is going to increase your social behavior, it is going to make you more social, it is going to modulate your emotional capacity, right? And one more thing it is going to do is that it is going to govern your emotions of fear and anxiety. Because the moment you reduce your fear, the moment you reduce your anxiety, that is the correct moment when you are less selfish. See, actually selfishness is not something, people have there for their own needs. Nobody is selfish for their needs. Needs are very easy to satisfy. People always find a way to satisfy their needs. So, selfish people are not selfish for their needs. Selfish people are selfish because of their dysfunction and disorder. People are not selfish because they need something. People are selfish because they fear to lose something they have. Because they fear to not have that thing. They fear to not experience that thing. They fear to have inferiority. So that is why selfishness is increasing. Because selfishness is not increasing because people want something, people need something, people think about themselves. No. Selfishness is increasing because people are less social and that's why they are thinking more about how to gain social acceptance. Okay. See, this is a very deep root. People are not selfish because they need something. People are not selfish because they need anything. Let's say people are selfish if they want luxury in life. Okay, many people will accept that. Yes, people are selfish because they want luxury in life. Think, why do they need luxury? People who are needing luxury, why do they need luxury? They need luxury for social acceptance. They need luxury for pleasure. They need luxury for self-contentment. So the need of luxury is again related to the social appearance of that person. And this social appearance is again related to what? Vasopressin. So vasopressin governs the social modality of a person, the way the person thinks in a social environment. And this, when this is disrupted, the person will think more about the self in the social environment and not about the social environment in which he is there. See, this is very two opposite things. Person thinking about himself in a social environment. Person thinking about social environment in which he is. Right? This is causing selfishness. This is not causing selfishness. So selfishness is something which is governed by vasopressin. And another thing which it would govern is the regulation of mutual coordination. Mutual coordination is the right word. Mutual coordination is developing a sense of attachment with people. How much you honor relationships, how much you honor relations, how much you honor people around you. So these are all governed by vasopressin. It will reduce selfishness. Another thing is it interacts with oxytocin. So this is the main hormone. When it interacts with oxytocin, it gives the maternal feeling of emotions, the mother. See, that is why when a lady gets pregnant, they have a child, they get a little bit more emotional. Yes, every mother is inclined to their child, that is first and foremost. But why a sudden drift? Why a sudden drift in change? This sudden drift is because when you are holding your baby inside your womb, at that time the hormonal level changes totally. At that time, oxytocin and vasopressin help each other. And when these two hormones combine, it will give you a feeling of maternal love. It gives and enhances the emotional feeling towards the child, towards the environment. So you would see pregnant women are less selfish. See that. Mark, notice, observe. You see, there is no more knowledge in this world until it is observed. You can read thousands of books, you can get hundreds of degrees, but what you have observed is the absolute truth. So notice it. Oxytocin with vasopressin increases the maternal feeling of love. So it also increases the emotional range of a person. Emotional range is how much feelings they feel. The emotional range increases with this hormone. People tend to get more emotional. They understand the feelings of others. Right. And the other thing is the behavioral communication. Your communication also enhances. When you are having lack of communication, always notice these two hormones. Because that is something which is causing a lack of communications. Yes, it will take a lot of time to enhance and balance this, because it is a very huge, it plays a very huge role. Because it governs your blood pressure, it enhances your blood pressure, it enhances the the sugar level in your body. It is also connected with that thing, the sugar of the body. It is also connected with plasma inside your blood. People know plasma osmolality. Osmolality is the function of water inside the blood, how it cleanses you. So whenever the plasma is more, this hormone is going to release more. So whenever the body has a lack of red blood cells, at that time people are less selfish. That is something I have personally noticed. People with less red blood cells increase their plasma osmolarity and increase this hormone, and they are less selfish. I am not saying it degrees your diabetes. I am just giving an observation over here. So the next thing is also drugs and narcotics. Drugs also release and increase these hormones. There are few drugs, opioids and another drugs, THC. All these things increase the emotional quotient of the body by secreting and releasing and maintaining this hormone. You see, even cannabis, it reduces your heart rate. As soon as your heart rate is reduced, the vasopressin balance changes. As soon as your vasopressin balance changes, the oxytocin level changes. As soon as that changes, your mood changes. That's why you feel happy, you feel blissful, people laugh. Okay, so these are all hormone related things. I'm not at all saying you take these drugs, I'm just saying that this happens. So next is what does it reduce? It reduces the functions of your hydration in the body. Okay, it reduces your urination. Your urine is less diluted when the vasopressin is released more, and that is because it also affects the hormones in your collecting duct of your kidneys. So this is why your urine dilution will change. So as everyone says, and as you know, that everything in excess is very bad. So whenever one thing is got excess, there is excess in this circulation. The circulation of this reduces. The sacral is connected with the Ajna chakra. The sacral chakra, the Swadhisthana chakra, is connected with the Ajna chakra. Your hydration is connected with your third eye, your pituitary, and that pituitary is connected with your kidneys. The better the kidneys, the better the function of Swadhisthana chakra, the better your third eye would always be, your pituitary would always be. Okay. So if you want to increase your third eye, you must have miraculous kidney system. If you want to increase your kidney system, you must have a miraculous third eye. So talking more, it is going to make your urine less diluted, and that is going to create more problems. So it is not always necessary to increase that hormone, get more emotional, more social. Sometimes it is good to remain stagnant in your life, in your boundaries, to understand yourself. Okay, vayu nat javatu gamme baju vache revanu chu to jeevi sakcho, right? So this was vasopressin. The next hormone is corticotropin releasing hormone, CRH. It is a stress stress modulating hormone. Stress modulating because it controls mood disorders. It also controls alcohol vulnerability. It is seen that people with CRH levels going abnormals, they are more inclined towards drinking alcohol. They are more inclined towards taking alcohol. They get addicted towards alcohol. They need alcohol. From weekly, they go into alternate days, and then daily, and then again weekly. So you can't leave alcohol, and if you have alcoholic issues, you must control these CRH hormones, because it is a very much deep factor that causes addictions. If you are having any kind of addictions, it is due to CRH. If you want to remove your addictions in your life, control your CRH. May it be anything, cigarettes, alcohol, drugs, people, everything. Addictions can be of all types. Even people are addictions. You might be addicted to situations, you might be addicted to moods, people who are always want to feel happy are addicted to happiness. Whatever you want in excess is your addiction. Think what you want in excess. Think what you want without a reason. That is an addiction. Right? So whoever want to reduce any kind of addictions in their life, they have to balance this corticostatin releasing hormone CRH. It is also responsible for that mood disorder which creates cravings inside you. Okay, and it is also responsible for few more things like growth hormones, bipolarity. So it is necessary to handle this hormone. It is necessary to understand what you are feeling. So spend time with yourself. Think about why you need things. Think about what you need. Think about what you are having right now and what else you want to achieve. Spend time with yourself. The best way to manage this hormone is to spending time with yourself. And note this hormone. Whenever you want to remove any kind of addictions, spend time with yourself. And this hormone will also increase your immunal reactivity. How your immune system reacts when a disease comes. Does it take time? Does it wait for the disease to increase and then release? Does it quickly releases? Okay. So immunity is also born by this hormone. But I would not discuss this in major way because it is very deep. It will take hours if I am going to talk about immune reactivity. It is a very huge topic, how your immune system reacts. Not right now. So next thing is about this CRH hormones is desires. Just like vasopressin made people selfish, this hormone increases the desire nature of the person. If you see, people are more ambitious, they are desiring more in life. I want this, I want that, I need this, I need that. So this is all due to CRH hormone. Your desires increase. You get eating disorders. The timings of eating changes. So if you see three changes inside in your body, one is your desire getting increased. Second is you are getting addicted to things. You need this, you need that, you want this, your desire is getting more. And you are getting emotionally driven to things. You are having mood disorders, right? Then it is the problem of CRH. So first of all, if these three things combine, eating disorders, desires and moodiness, then it is CRH. And what you can do about it? First of all, you need to increase your adaptive behavior. It is very important to increase your adaptive behavior because this hormone is going to dysregulate your social behavior. It is going to dysregulate, cut down your adaptive behavior. Which hormone was making your social behavior more active? Vasopressin. We just talked about it. It increases your social behavior. But CRH, it decreases your social behavior. What does it do? It lets you think about yourself. Right? So, increase your adaptive behavior. Take things that increase testosterone level in your body, that things will increase your vasopressin. As soon as your vasopressin is increased, CRH is reduced. Okay. So that is how you control that thing. That is how you control your desires. To control your selfishness, it was vasopressin. To control your addictions and desires is your CRH. Now comes corticostatin. This is the next step. The third one. So what does this do? This corticostatin is a very much important hormone which increases your attentiveness, your learning and formulating inside your body. It is going to give you a growth mindset. If your corticostatin is higher, you are going to have a growth mindset. What is a growth mindset? The input power of the brain will increase than the output power. We are more observant. You are more open to changes. You are more open to adaptations. You are more open to take things seriously. Right? It is also going to reduce your addictiveness. If you are again talking about addictiveness, it is going to increase your addictiveness, and you are going to understand more about things you are addicted to. So when you increase your corticostatin, it is going to make you more formulative in nature. It will give you a growth mindset, learning mind. Your input will increase and your output will decrease. When your input increases, you are learning. You have a growth mindset. You want to grow. When your output is increasing, you are not growing. You are just executing things you have learned. જેટલું ખાધું છે ને એને વાપરી છે, જ્યારે આઉટપુટ દઈ છે ને ત્યારે નવું નથી આવતું. ખાધેલી વસ્તુ વાપરી છે, જ્યારે ઇનપુટ લે છે ને ત્યારે નવું ખાય છે, જ્યારે નવું ખાય છે ને ત્યારે ગ્રો થાય છે. રાઈટ? જ્યારે આઉટપુટ દે છે ત્યારે ગ્રો નથી થતો. ગ્રો થઈ ગયા છે, ગ્રો ત્યાર પછી એ વસ્તુને વાપરવી કેમ, એ આઉટપુટ દે છે. આઉટપુટ ઇઝ ગિવિંગ ફ્રૂટ્સ. ઝાડવું મોટું નથી થતું, ઝાડવું જેવડું છે એવડું જ રહે છે ને એમાં ફળ આવે છે. ધેટ ઇઝ ગિવિંગ આઉટપુટ. ઇનપુટ ઇઝ ઝાડવું મોટું કરવું. ઇનપુટ જેટલું વધારશો ને એટલું ઝાડવું મોટું થશે. ફ્રૂટ નહીં આવે, ફ્રૂટ જોતા હશે ને ત્યારે આઉટપુટ વધારવું પડશે. બે જરૂરી છે, એવરીથિંગ ઇઝ નેસેસરી. ઝાડવું વધારો, ફ્રૂટ લ્યો. ઝાડવું વધારો, ફ્રૂટ લ્યો. ઇન્ડિયન સોસાયટીને શું કરેલું છે? વોટ ડઝ ઇન્ડિયન સોસાયટી ડુ? ટીલ ધ એજ ઓફ 22-24 ઝાડવું વધારી લીધું. 6 ફૂટનું થઈ ગયું. 24 પછીની આખી જિંદગીમાં એ આઉટપુટ જ દે છે. 24 સુધીમાં જે ભણ્યો નહીં માણસ, ઝાડવું વધ્યું 6 ફૂટનું થયું અને 6 ફૂટના ઝાડવા ફ્રૂટ આવી રાખે, પછી એને કઈ પડી જ નથી ઝાડવા ઉગાડવા, પછી એને આઉટપુટ જ દેવું છે. એકી હારે દોડી લીધું 6 ફૂટ, પછી ત્યાં આવીને થાકીને બેસી ગયા અને પછી ત્યાંથી ફ્રૂટ લીધે રાખા. દેટ ઇઝ વન વે ઓફ લિવિંગ. આઈ માય સેલ્ફ ડોન્ટ કન્સિડર દેટ લિવિંગ એઝ અ પરફેક્ટ લિવિંગ. કેમ રહેવું જોઈએ? 4 ફૂટ ઝાડવું ઉગાડ્યું, ફ્રૂટ દીધું. પાછું 2 ફૂટ ઝાડવું ઉગાડ્યું, ફ્રૂટ કાઢ્યા. પાછા 2 ફૂટ ઝાડવું. સિઝનમાં કેમ ઉગે છે ઝાડવું? એક ઝાડવું એવું જોઈએ 6 વર્ષ 8 વર્ષ 10 વર્ષ સુધી લાંબુ થાય પછી ફ્રૂટ આપે રાખે, એવું ન હોય. એવરી સિઝન ઇઝ મેડ ફોર ફ્રૂટ, એવરી સિઝન ઇઝ મેડ ફોર ઇન્ક્રીઝિંગ ધ લેન્થ. એવરી યર વર્ષમાં પહેલા ભાગમાં ઝાડવું મોટું થાય છે, વર્ષના બીજા ભાગમાં ઝાડવું ફ્રૂટ દે છે. મોટું થાય છે, ફ્રૂટ દે છે, મોટું થાય છે, ફ્રૂટ દે છે. એ સાયકલ ફોલો કરે છે નેચર. તમે કહું તો હાલો, તમે કહું તો હાલો છો નેચરથી. દેટ ઇઝ વોટ નેચર વોન્ટ્સ. ગ્રો, ગીવ આઉટપુટ. ગ્રો મોર, ગીવ મોર આઉટપુટ. ગ્રો અગેન મોર, ગીવ મોર આઉટપુટ. વોટ ઇઝ ઇન્ડિયન સોસાયટી ગવર્મેન્ટ ડુઈંગ? એજ્યુકેશન સિસ્ટમ ડુઈંગ? ગ્રો 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 ટુ અ લિમિટ, ધેન સિટ ઓન ધેટ લિમિટ એન્ડ કીપ ગીવિંગ ફ્રૂટ્સ, ધેન ડોન્ટ ગ્રો અહેડ. આગળ નહીં વધો, પછી એટલું જ ભણો, એટલું ભણીને શીખી લ્યો અને એમાંથી ફળ બીજે રાખો. એનાથી વધારે નહીં ભણો, એનાથી વધારે આગળ નહીં વધો. સો ગ્રોથ હોર્મોન ઇઝ એન ઇમ્પોર્ટન્ટ ફેક્ટર. યુ નીડ ટુ બેલેન્સ ઇનપુટ એન્ડ આઉટપુટ ઓફ ધ બોડી. સિમિલરલી લર્નિંગ માઇન્ડસેટ. વેન યુ આર મોર ફોકસ્ડ ઓન ઇનપુટ, યુ હેવ અ લર્નિંગ માઇન્ડસેટ વિથ અ હાઈ કોર્ટિકોસ્ટેટિન લેવલ. ધેન યુ આર ગિવિંગ આઉટપુટ વિથ વેસોપ્રેસિન. Corticostatin is reduced. So what I am saying is, for few part of the year, be on input side. For few part of the year, be on output side. How to decide that? That's by thermal level of the body. Vasopressin increases heart rate. Your thermal level is going to enhance. You will feel more warm. So what is the best time to feel warm? Winter. So in winter, always be growth, always be output oriented. Give more output, increase your vasopressin, increase your thermal level of the body, right? And again, when summer comes, reduce your vasopressin, reduce your output, focus on growth, grow higher and higher, grow 10 more branches of your tree. And again, when winter comes, you will have 10 more branches to give fruits. Then again, the next summer, grow 10 more another branches. And the next winter, you will have 20 more branches for fruits. Right? Give output, grow. Give output, grow. Give double output, grow. Give triple output, grow. Give four times output, grow. Okay. So, vasopressin is for winter. Corticostatin is for summer. In summertime, you can increase your corticostatin levels and reduce in winter. Vasopressin you can increase in winter and reduce in summer. It will adapt your body with nature. It will also give your body adaptive nature. Your body will adapt with seasons. Your body will adapt with moods. Right? Because you are flickering your heartbeats. When there is winter, the outward environment is chilled. You are increasing your heart rate and increasing your thermal level. Just to adapt with the season. Similarly, when you are again in summer, you are reducing it. You are doing more yoga. You are doing less meditation. In winter, meditate more. Don't focus on flexibility of muscles in winter. You have to make your muscles tighter and tighter in winter so that vasopressin is released more. When you increase the flexibility of the muscles, when you increase hydration in your body, corticostatin increases. That is the summer thing. Don't do it in winter. In winter, you meditate. Make your muscles in strain. Keep your muscles tight. In summer, make it loose. But it is a very difficult task to maintain this thing every year. You should have a firm mindset. But yes, if you are more focused in mental health and health, physical health, this is the best way to live throughout a year. Just like nature has given seasons, the same seasons we have to follow. We have to follow the same seasonal rules that nature has implemented on trees. We are as much as the child of nature as trees are, as animals are, as the soil is, as the water is. So it is important to know and study the nature. How it wants you to live a life. Don't live a life how you want to live. Because what you want to do is your desire. What is your desire? Corticostatin. It gives you desire. So desire is your corticostatin. Don't follow one hormone in your body. You'll get addicted. Don't follow your desires. Follow what is needed in the environment and at the situation. That is how you enhance your adaptability of your body and mind with the nature. The last thing is a stress response of corticostatin. This hormone also gives stress response. It is going to give you responsiveness towards muscular stress. So whenever there is stress in the muscles, this hormone is automatically released. It gives feedback to CRH and it releases another hormones in your body so that hydration level increases, your circulatory level increases, neural circulation also increases. So it is also a stress related issue. If you are more stressful, first of all, what you need to do is to reduce stress. Exercise. Don't focus on this hormone in the winter until and unless you have done yoga in summer. If you have not made yourself flexible in summertime, don't meditate in winter. You are going to reduce your energies. Okay, think about a rubber band. If you pull your rubber band, slowly it will learn to stretch. you pull rubber band 10 times like this and then keep it pulled for 10 minutes, it won't break. But if you take new rubber band, okay, and if you keep pull and if you keep it for 5 minutes, it will break. Why? Because the rubber has not adapted to the flexibility which is needed. Right? Similarly is the body. Until and unless you have practiced yoga, practice flexibility in the summer season, the winter is going to be tough for you. But if you have practiced flexibility in summer, your body muscles are now flexible enough to hold yourself in stress in winter. Right? So, exercise in summer, meditate in winter. Don't meditate in winter until and unless you exercise in summer, because otherwise your body muscles will get tighter and tighter and tighter, and then you will have what? Joint problems. Knee joint, hip joint, elbow joint. Just because you are sitting in one position for 2 to 3 hours while you are meditating, you will have issues related to your joints. So it is important to understand and keep your body adaptive in seasons. Right? So this is it. This is the first part of pituitary gland, in which we discussed four hormones. As I said, pituitary is a very long thing. I am going to give you the next video coming up right next to this in this forum. Till then, understand these four hormones, understand why it is specifically necessary to adapt with seasons, understand why selfishness is reacted from one hormone, desires and addictions are released and made from another hormones. Okay. So, thank you for this video. This video and this pituitary gland is continued. I am going to give next video within 2 hours. Thank you for watching.